or don't ever try. So I'm telling you, do or don't ever try the graduating class of La-Brea RC 2022. You are truly the chosen generation because you are walking successfully through an endemic. You are a group of not just industrious and fun students, but affectionate and courageous. You are the epitome of what Mahatma Gandhi said, be that change that you want to see in the world. You encountered many obstacles throughout the years, even a pandemic. And here you are, sophisticated, with your chins up, crossing a finish line. You transformed like Megatron and conquered the challenges of working from home, becoming this generation's whiz kids. We learn together and we face the difficulties together. As you put your best foot forward and begin the new chapter of your life, secondary school, walk like a gazelle with your confidence and take with you your faith. Be charismatic and assertive in your decision. And just as Nike said, just do it.
Time to master of ceremony, Mrs. Martin. Graduating class of 2022. Fellow members of staff and the La-Brea RC family, good afternoon. It is a great pleasure and indeed an honor for me to bring a few words to you, the graduating class of 2022. We know it has been 7 long years for some of you and maybe a little longer for others. And the journey was one with ups and downs, trials and tribulation, especially since March 2020. But this afternoon, whenever we have occasions like these, we focus on the positive, not so much on the negative. So we're going to focus on a few positive things. So within the last year, which is 2021 to 2022, you were asked to come out. And before you did that, we had all your teachers who were working with you. So first, I would like to congratulate the teachers who have brought you to this stage from infants to standard fives. I know in one class in particular, you had one teacher for same standard two, but the others, you will have some interact with some other teachers. So I want to congratulate all the teachers for bringing you at this stage. But in February 2022, you were asked to come out physically after being home for almost 2 years. And at this time, I want to send a special mention to the standard five teachers, Ms. Leibert and Mrs. Ramgosain. They answered the call without hesitation or fuss. And what is more particular and pleasing to me as principal, they made my job a little easier because, you know, we had some new protocols to follow. And the teachers were here religiously every morning, early even before me, to make and ensure that you were here. Even before that, we were challenged because we had some infrastructure thing work to get done. And the lights weren't the best, but they worked through it. Thank you. Thankfully, we first had the Ministry of Works who came and fixed the lights, and later on, closer to sea, we had the Ministry of Education who did a thorough thing to the schools. So I also want to thank these people, but your teachers stayed there with you, right? So today, as we transition, as Ms. Ramgosain said, from a new journey from primary to secondary, you have a lot of things to look forward to. But today is your day. As we say, we do not have your parents or others here with you, but we know they will be seeing it via a link that will be shared. So we are happy that you are here today. It's Child Center. It's about your day. We want you to enjoy your day. Before I close, there are a few people I know we will have a vote of thanks. But as I said, we want to focus on the positive things that came out during your stay. Even during your stay, as we came back out, I would like to thank Trinidad Generation Unlimited. Because usually they have a program where they run excellent education and they weren't able to do it for about a few years. And they came and they did it in La-Brea RC. And we were the first school they were able to do it with, and it was successful. And I remember Ms. Williams, the corporate manager of, communication manager of TGU, always saying, Mr. Charles, I like how La-Brea RC is always organized. So I'm saying that with all the help of my teachers, and we were able to pull off that event successfully. And just like that event, I was telling my teachers, we have two other events. One was the registration of the infants, which went smoothly. and this our graduation, which is going smoothly. So I would also like to thank all the others. I know, as I said, we have a vote of thanks, but their parents for going with the idea. I know when it's graduation, parents like to be present, but because of COVID and new normal, the teachers have an idea. We want it to be your day, and we're making it your day. So before anything, I just want you to stay back, relax, enjoy. We have one child, even a little handicapped, but he's here, and I'm happy that he's able here to join us. So that is to show the spirit and love we have at the La-Brea team. So enjoy your day, and thank you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Heavenly Father, as we gather here to celebrate the accomplishment of an important milestone in our lives, we humbly thank you for allowing us this opportunity. We pray that today's proceedings will be successful and that each of us will have an enjoyable time. In your name we pray. Amen.
Hello everyone, I am Crystal Wilson. I am a journalist, news presenter, producer with TTT Limited. And I'm particularly happy to have been asked to extend congratulations to this beautiful La-Brea RC class of 2022. I want to say congratulations to all of you. You have worked hard. You are deserving of where you are today. And I also want to let you all know that there are absolutely no limits. People say the sky is the limit. But trust and believe when I tell you, there are absolutely no limits to this journey called life. Trust yourselves. Believe in yourselves. Crave and desire success so badly it is all that consumes you. Pick your friends very wisely. Associate with the people who are going to uplift you, who are going to help you become the people that you want to be. You all are a beautiful bunch. You all are an amazing bunch. And I want to say congratulations again to all of you, your parents, your guardians, your grannies, your aunties, your uncles, your teachers. Bless all of you and congratulations again. All the best on your journey.
Greetings to the graduating class of La-Brea RC Primary School. My name is Jesse Ramdeo, a journalist and news presenter at CNC3 News. Thank you all so very much for having me. It's an absolute honor to be with you, though virtually, and share in your shining moment. Let me also acknowledge the teachers, staff, and parents as well, and congratulate each of you for your dedicated role in the student's journey. So for those who may not know, I was born and raised right in Point Fortin. The borough was my home for much of my life, so I'm very familiar with the La-Brea RC Primary School. And I deliberately mentioned where I grew up because there are a lot of people who are so surprised when they hear that I'm from Point Fortin, as if the southwestern part of the island cannot produce excellence. And therein is my message to you students. I want you all to continue striving for excellence. Prove people wrong. Dream big and work hard. I certainly don't know you all personally, but I know that you all have the heart and courage to take on whatever lies ahead. You are resilient. Students, represent your family, your school, and your community with pride as you enter what I consider one of the most important chapters in your life. I'm really, really proud of everyone, and my hope is that we know one day I can feature you in our newscast for your outstanding achievement in whatever you decide to pursue. So today, I challenge you to one day make it into the news because of your greatness. So with that, I want to bid you all, the students of the La-Brea RC Primary School, congratulations, all the very, very best, and continue, as I said before, striving for excellence. Please continue to put your best foot forward. I'm so very proud of you, right? And continue, as mentioned before, to be resilient. That's my message for now. Bye, students.
After 3 years in preschool, we finally reach what we like to call big school. We feel we old, we feel where we're supposed to be, so we feeling real cool. From learning our ABCs to making friendships, I think we could all agree this is where we began making our core memories. Some of us couldn't fit in the infant table, so we're sitting in the big chair and seats as if we could write C, but lo and behold, we now learning how to write properly. Now, my class had one heck of a second year. Sports day, we painted our faces, we bunny hopped across the whole field, hoping to reach the end, and we all prayed that this day will never yield. From marching up and down all that time and not knowing what we're doing, to be emerging Mr. Redhead class, and boy, were there something to deal with. But the one and only Bisessa, some called her crazy, some said she was scary, while others said she was very friendly. And the truth is, without her, we would have never been able to meet the next character in our story. Now, in standard one, we received the character called Mrs. Smith. And boy, was she one to deal with. From the notes to the games, we gave trouble in every different way, but she stuck with it all. She came in her bottle of holy water every day. And she helped us make it to standard one, as I recall. She taught us everything from Spanish to social studies to mathematics to the states of matter. It was so good at this point we didn't think it could get better. But as the saying goes, we never know what tomorrow holds. So as I said, we never know what tomorrow holds. Well, in standard two, we had some ups and downs beyond our own control. From finding out Miss Alexander was sick and having Mr. Redhead and Miss Shantha and I to quickly meeting Miss Bedina, one of our auditees who soon basically became our own teacher. It all went pretty fast, but I'm kind of glad to say this moment didn't last. We also got Mr. Charles as our principal, which is quite fun to say the least. See, always making stale jokes, talking too fast or too slow. Needless to say the least, he was never the biggest feat. Standard three, I'm not going to waste any more of the people's time. I'm going to jump straight to the good part of this year. We finally upstairs. The moment we've been dreaming about since first year at orientation, we say, Mommy, one day, I going to be up there. And here we are, up there. Now we realize we're excited about nothing besides stress, Miss Lynch and her. Interesting keys. And well, let's say after leaving her, we know how to form with A, B's, and C's. This year also brought an unusual surprise they call COVID. This was a struggle to say the least, as classes went home and then discovered the thing they call online learning, which is an unknown beast. In standard four, we still online trying to figure things out, but now we discover online learning wasn't the only beast we're gonna come across. We found the officer, the prison guard, the sergeant, and more, the one everybody does run from, the one your parents warned you about to behave for since first year. This miss had us drilling maths like we were studying to be mathematicians and gonna be the next profession. And boy, oh boy, does she have a unique way expressing her emotions. Somehow, she always found a new way of teaching and making a lesson fun. Needless to say, this class was an unexpected one. Standard five, we see, and finally, the end is near. We could see the finish line, practically taste the victory in the air, but what was it all for? To write an exam and say we did good, that's not worth the 7 years of stress for me. I can't describe how I feel in one word. We always say, try, try, try. But what trying really gonna do for you? After months of studying for SEA, just to break down and fail because you forgot a word? Trying not gonna do anything for you. Miss and Miss taught us that. They held our hand and walked baby steps with us through practically in front of the paper for you to sit down while hearing the instructions, crack under the pressure, forget your name, and then break down with fear and shame. I could bet every single organ in my body that's how we all felt at some point. But we did it. It's finished, we're here to celebrate it. I could easily say after 7 or 6 years with all you, I fed up all you. All you drive me mad. but it was worth the insanity. Needless to say, while attending La-Brea RC, I created a whole new family.
As this season is coming to an end in our lives, I would like to send gratitude to the teachers and the principal for giving this opportunity to graduate. 7 years of hard work from the students, teachers, and parents all paid off. The teachers that have taught us at their class were Miss Lynch, Miss Grenade, Miss Johnson, Mr. Lewis, Miss Smith, Miss Lybert, Miss Lamson, Mr. Charles, Miss Chen, and we cannot forget Miss Alexander. May she continue to rest in peace. They were and still are the people that put the time and effort to bring us where we are today. And a special thanks to the school guards for keeping the school safe. You worked long, hard hours ensuring the safety of the occupants of La-Brea RC.
In the near future, my friends, we will begin a new chapter in our lives, secondary school. I know that we are all excited, nervous, and afraid because we are uncertain of what this future may hold. But what I do know is we will learn new subjects, meet new friends and teachers, and we will learn new skills and our personalities may change. There will be disappointments, but there will also be achievements along the way. When faced with challenge, remember to do your best and be yourselves, as Ms. Ramson would always say. Do not forget, Peter pay for Paul and Paul pay for all. It has truly been an amazing 7 years at this school, and our time here has helped us to grow as people. I will remember the good and the bad times here. Remember, do or don't, never just try.
Representatives from the Catholic Board of Education, Ministry of Educational Personnel, the principal, members of the PTA, members of staff, parents, and our guests of honor, the graduating class of 2022. Good afternoon. My name is Ms. Gopi, and I am honored to be here today to propose this vote of thanks on behalf of La-Brea RC School and on my own behalf. I think we can all agree that our graduation ceremony this evening has been a resounding success. And for this, we are grateful. Words of gratitude may not be enough to properly express our appreciation to all those who have contributed to this successful event, but I will continue on regardless. Thank you. Thank you to all supporting and administrative bodies whose guidance and support we rely on for the efficient management of our school. The Catholic Education Board of Management, the Ministry of Education, and in particular, the supervisory staff of the St. Patrick Education District. TUTA, our Parent Teacher Association, to you we express our sincere gratitude. Thank you to all companies and organizations who generously contributed toward our event. Trinidad Generations Limited, TGU, Atlantic LNG, Caribbean Gas and Chemical Limited, CGCL, Rico's Contracting Limited, SM Jalil and Company, Solo Beverages, Bermudas Limited, The Carib Brewery, Erin Farms, K Kiss Baking Company Limited. We thank you. Thank you to all persons right here at home, our La-Brea RC home, who have given of themselves in support of this graduation ceremony. Our school principal, members of staff, parents, students, we thank you. To those who have sent their greetings and well wishes, thank you. And to all the unknown hands who contributed to the success of this program, we are truly grateful. Once again, I would like to express my sincere gratitude, our sincere gratitude. May God bless each and every one of you. May God bless you, our children. And good afternoon to all of you again.
Graduates, graduating class of 2022. This time, just like all teachers, we are filled. We are filled with two emotions. The emotion of happiness and sadness. We are happy because we are seeing the fruits of our labor as we sit, as you sit, and we stand and we look at you. We are indeed proud of what you have achieved. But we are sad because we know that this is our farewell to you. So we are asking that you bear with us. And I know I'm a bit emotional because around this time usually I'm emotional. So dear graduates, may God bless you with success and prosperity. This is a new beginning for you. And I want you to remember these few things. Nothing can stop you now. You have a ticket, and that ticket is to ensure that your dreams come true. What is your ticket? Your mind, the education that you received. Make your dream come true. You may encounter failure. Never get upset with failure. Failure just gives you another opportunity to begin again, another journey. Embrace it. Set your goals. You have spoken today about goals. There is no limit to your goal. Set your goal. Always dream. Dream big. Because your dream and your aspiration and where you are going to reach is as only big as your dream. We at La-Brea RC School, we have given to you knowledge, skills, and wisdom that you need for life. From now on, it is your journey. Let it be a continuous, improving journey as you go along. And finally, it is really sad, as I said, to see you leave. But in my heart and in the hearts of all here, we know that you have been fully being prepared for your next phase of life. Never stop learning. And most importantly, never stop winning. Congratulations to all of you. And as we bid you farewell, we want you to remember, and don't ever forget, do or don't, never. Excellent. So we wish you farewell. We know that you would come and visit us again. We know that you will come and see us again. And we want you to know that we will forever have you in our thoughts. Bye. Pleasant afternoon to you.
I am a lion, and yes, I'm a fighter. For my book, yes, I'll be the writer. Blessed love, this is Kes, and I want to congratulate the La-Brea RC graduating class of 2022. I wish you the very best on your future and on your dreams. I hope you continue to explore all of those dreams and grow in love and grow in respect. And yes, just grow fully. Blessed love to you from me, Kes. And you know what? The theme is do or don't, never just try. So keep on trying, keep on pushing, and keep on thriving to do the big things that I know you're gonna do. Yeah? Blessed love. Yeah. Everybody on stage, oh Lord, oh, if you're coming down from the mountain, oh God, oh, when the rhythm beating in tongue, I see you jumping on the savanna grass, the savanna grass. You could see it all when it does raise a ladder. When the people tell you they cannot wait to gather, feel the spirit jumping in tongue. We coming wrong, the savanna grass, the savanna grass. We up with the sun. We take over tongue, we make